गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल। इफ आई एम ऑडिबल प्लीज पुट द कमेंट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स सो दैट आई विल गेट द फीडबैक यू आर एबल टू हियर इट। एम आई ऑडिबल? गुड मॉर्निंग, थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग। डॉक्टर सुमैया, रवि कुमार, शिवराम, दीप्ति, भक्ति, थैंक यू ऑल फॉर ज्वाइनिंग। विद इन 5 मिनट्स वी विल स्टार्ट द सेशन। आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल। काइंडली जस्ट पुट अ कमेंट एंड so within 5 minutes we will start the session। thank you all for joining। dr pv piyush, dr ujwal, dr robin, rohan, srishti, dr haidar, dr mitesh, thank you all for joining। It is possible that during this session there can be some technical issue. If there is a issue, you can put the comment in the comment box so that I will do the necessary changes. So somewhere around 11:05 we will start the actual session. Meanwhile people will join. If you have any question related to this, you can put. Already I have received more than 25 questions which people like to know the answers. Other than this, if you have any question, please put into the comment box so that I will try to give the answer. Thank you Dr. Prajakta, Manali, Dr. Sudesh, Asif. I hope all are fine at the home and the workplaces. Welcome Dr. Sandeep Bhagwat sir. Just now sir has joined. We'll start the session. Dr. Varun, welcome. Since last 2 months we all are suffering from COVID lockdown of that, and that has affected our profession, our practices badly. So today's session is just to address that problems, issues, questions which a physiotherapist is facing in this period. Thank you Mrityunjay. Dr. Mrityunjay is doing a wonderful work. He is the frontline worker, health worker, who is doing the screening of migrant laborers who are coming from all parts of the country to Patna, and he is the one who is doing the thermal scanning of all these migrant laborers. Even at 4 a.m. in the morning, he is reaching to the railway stations and doing that noble work. We appreciate Dr. Mrityunjay. So COVID, today's session, why I have decided to come on the live, because I never came, this is the first time I came on FB. Since last वन एंड हाफ मंथ आई वॉज गेटिंग रिपीटेडली क्वेश्चंस. आई हैड टू टू थ्री वेबिनार्स जूम मीटिंग्स ऑल्सो टू एड्रेस ऑल दिस इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू द प्रैक्टिस एंड द लीगेलिटी एक्शन रिलेटेड टू दैट इन दिस कोविड पीरियड. बट आई थिंक इवन थ्रू द व्हाट्सअप एंड अदर सोशल मीडिया आई वॉज एड्रेसिंग दैट इश्यूज. बट आई थिंक दैट वॉज नॉट सफिशियंट बिकॉज स्टिल द पीपल हैव सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस. पीपल हैव लॉट ऑफ एंग्जिटी फियर दैट इज टोटली बिकॉज ऑफ केयर एंड वी आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट द एग्जैक्ट नेचर ऑफ दिस डिसीज. कोविड हैज अफेक्टेड आर प्रैक्टिसेस. मोस्ट ऑफ द क्लिनिक्स आर क्लोज. इनिशियली इट वॉज देयर लॉकडाउन वन. नाउ पीपल आर इन द मूड टू स्टार्ट द क्लिनिक्स एंड ऑलरेडी फ्यू पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड द क्लिनिक एंड दे हैव मेनी लीगल इश्यूज इन रिलेशन टू दैट. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन पुट इट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स सो दैट आई विल ट्राई टू रीच टू दैट. आई विल ट्राई टू एड्रेस एज मच एज पॉसिबल बिकॉज देर इज अ ह्यूज लिस्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. And within 1 or 2 minutes, we'll start with the actual session. I hope all are safe at home and at workplaces also. We are the healthcare providers, service provider, and it is our duty to provide the services in this period. Welcome, Amit Gire sir, Apurva, Dr. Sadhana. So we'll start the session now. Thank you all for joining the Facebook Live. This session, mostly what I am going to do, I am dividing in two segments. The first segment is related to the problems faced by the physiotherapist of Maharashtra and related to the council. And second, overall, all the physiotherapists of the country and the commonly asked questions. So the first thing is Maharashtra State OTPT Council. Since last 2 months, the council office is completely closed because of the COVID lockdown and the directives from the government. Hence, the function of the council office is completely affected. The registration process is completely stopped. The certificate issue, that is also completely stopped, and people are having problems in relation with that. Also, the renewal certificates we are not able to generate and provide that to the candidates. The major issue was related to the good standing certificate and the email verification. The people who are willing to go abroad in next academic year for the education as well as for the practice, they are having a tough time with this. From my side, personally tried to reply to the as much as possible email, but there were some issues. And in relation to that, we have taken one meeting on Wednesday 20th. And where we have taken few decisions to give some relief to the all these practitioners. So the first decision which we have taken in relation to the renewal certificate is that online procedure is there. You can apply on the online, but the certificate we are unable to give it to the all the practitioners. So the decision is taken that till the period of lockdown, the receipt of renewal will be considered as the valid proof of renewal of this registration. So even though if you are not having any renewal certificate, your receipt of payment will be considered as a legal proof for this. So that will solve most of the issues of practitioners. And we have yesterday only we have published one notification that will come on the website in some time. So receipt is a proof for renewal. Second thing is that we are aware that the practices are affected, clinics are not working, the council office is also closed, and council charges fine for the delay in the renewal. After the expiry, there is a 1 month grace period, and if you are not applying in that period, fine of 500 rupees per year, that fine is taken. Our council has taken the decision to cancel all the fines of the professionals whose registration is expired or is going to get expired from 1st January 2020 to 31st December 2020. इतने पीरियड में जिसका भी रजिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपायर हो रहा है एंड इफ देर इज अ डिले इन द रिन्यूअल द काउंसिल हैज कंप्लीटली वेव्ड ऑफ ऑल द फाइन सो देर विल बी नो फाइन पुट टू द एनी ऑफ द प्रैक्टिसनर जिसका रजिस्ट्रेशन 1 जनवरी से 31 दिसंबर 2020 तक एक्सपायर होगा. आई थिंक दिस इज अ गुड डिसीजन एंड आई एम थैंकफुल टू ऑल द काउंसिल मेंबर्स फॉर दैट. द थर्ड डिसीजन विच वी हैव टेकन इट इज अ सिंपल थिंग. मेनी प्रैक्टिसनर्स इन्फॉर्म्ड अस दैट देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम इन टेकिंग द फोटोज ऑन द एप्रन बिकॉज इन काउंसिल वी थिंक that is a rule in the council and council asked the people to upload the photos on the apron. People said that in the lockdown period all the shops are closed, it is not possible to upload the photos. I said you can click it from the mobile also, but most of the people are having lockdown, they are at home, aprons are at their clinics, so they said that some relief has to be given. So we have taken a decision that till the lockdown period, this rule, there will be the relaxation. You can put whatever your photo is there without the apron, you can put that. Once the lockdown is over and at the time of certificate generation, the council office will contact you and again you have to upload that. So this relaxation is given. Next relaxation is given to the good standing certificate. The people who are the students which are going in the next academic year, they are facing the problem because now their verification has to be done. Their cases are with their respective councils, international councils, and there was a problem in giving the good standing certificates because as per the foreign council laws, the hard copy is mandatory. We have discussed with the Australian and Canadian council, candidates have discussed with the Canadian council, and I have spoken to the few officers of Australian council, and now these councils have temporarily changed their rules and they have informed us that even if you will provide soft copy, we will accept it. That is a good thing for them. Also, the second thing is that the Australian council has shown, yesterday we got the mail from the council, they showed interest in doing MOU with Maharashtra State OTPT Council, Memorandum of Understanding between Australian Council and Maharashtra State OTPT Council. They said that we are interested in that so that this verification will be done in few minutes. So after lockdown, we will work on that and we will give the faster services and relaxation to the people who are aspiring to go abroad for the education and other work related thing. In this time, we have also noted that the colleges of Maharashtra, which are having and were due for the inspections, their validity of the recognition letter that has expired or it is going to get expired during this year, and because of lockdown, we were unable to conduct the inspection. So to give relief to these colleges, because academic year will start after few months, we have taken a decision to give the relaxation and 1 year provisional extension to the recognition. That means jiska recognition expire ho raha tha 2020 mein, that will be extended till 31st December 2020. The notification of that will be published today on the website. We have already published in the council. We have created one COVID window on the council website where we have promoted the education, and we asked the physiotherapist, occupational therapist to do that, and we got a good response from the all the professionals and volunteers also. We got a good response. The female physiotherapist have showed more interest in providing the services voluntarily in COVID than the male. That is the good thing. I appreciate it. The next thing is that since last few weeks, unofficially and officially from different channels, I was social media, I was informing about the what we are supposed to do, but official advisory has not been published by the council. We are in the process and we have yet we are finalizing that, and within 2-3 days we'll publish the official advisory of Maharashtra State OTPT Council along with the legal inputs in that advisory. During this time, we also found that many physiotherapists are facing problems at their workplace. The workplace was BMC, government, or even private hospitals. They were not getting the proper PPEs. Also, they were forced to do the COVID duties, and no facilities was given to them. On contrary, other healthcare professions, they were getting the PPEs. So we got a complaints from most of the hospitals, and for that I have written a letter to CM of Maharashtra, Deputy CM, Finance Minister, and as well as the Health Minister, Medical Education Minister, and the Commissioner of Mumbai. And we have requested them. We requested CM to kindly give us the insurance to all the private practitioners, physiotherapists who are working in the private clinics and hospitals. At present, the central government has given the insurance of 50 lakhs and state government of Maharashtra has also given the insurance of 50 lakhs. So total 1 crore insurance is given to the healthcare workers. The criteria eligibility is that the person should be posted or deployed in COVID services. It can be administrative or it can be a clinical one. If the person is deployed in that, the person will get the insurance. Same hospital, physios who are providing services in the non-COVID, they are not covered under this, even in the government setup. And private, it is not at all covered. If it is a COVID center, then person can get the coverage. So we requested the ministry and CM to make a policy so that the physiotherapists who are working in the private hospital and clinics, they will also get covered in this. We are aware that after this, so many reforms are going to take place in healthcare system. And for that purpose, from beginning, we are taking this effort. We have asked for 4 demands. Second, third, 4 demands, they are fulfilled at that the same time. Insurance, we are working on that. And after COVID, Government of Maharashtra is coming with some policy for all healthcare workers. So, usme hamara claim chahiye. For that purpose, we have started effort for insurance from now. It can be 5 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. But whenever it will come, my physiotherapist, my occupational therapist should get that facility. For we have demanded that. We also demanded to make the accommodation facility of physios who are enrolled and given the COVID duties in the same campus or hotels nearby the campus. Safety, PPE, facility of PPE. And also we requested state government that if a physiotherapist become positive, do not put them in a facility which is for the common public. Unfortunately, one physiotherapist from one of the reputed hospital from Mumbai got infected, and she was kept at a center which was not that much good. It was an unhygienic center, and she has raised her concern. That concern reached to us. She was from Varali area, the local minister from that area. I have informed that to them, and from her side also she has informed to the different authorities, and the authorities has taken care. She was shifted to some better place. So we requested that a healthcare worker is something different from common person. The severity of infection can be different. Hence, separate facility for healthcare workers has to be given. Government is doing that. And quarantine also, the facility has to be given at the home quarantine. Do not quarantine the healthcare workers at common public. That we are supposed to do. Now, second segment of this talk is relation with the physiotherapist problems faced during this, questions and the answer to that in a legal terminology. Prior to that, I want to appreciate physiotherapist. Those physiotherapists who are providing their services in COVID, non-COVID hospitals and to the society. Because without mentioning this, I think it is not appropriate to talk about COVID. I want to thank all the physiotherapists of government sector, central government physiotherapist, various state government physiotherapist, physiotherapist working in the government autonomous bodies. I want to thank them because they are working in the COVID center in different capacities, administration as well as clinical. I want to thank them. Thank you to the physiotherapist of DMER, physiotherapist of DHS of state of Maharashtra, and special thanks to the largest COVID hospital of Mumbai, because we in the Mumbai have the largest number of corona in India. And I am proud to say that our physiotherapist team, headed by Chaya Verma madam from Nair Hospital, they are taking care of ICU, COVID ICU and administration work of that. Thank you Chaya madam and all the team. And I really appreciate the postgraduate students of Nair Hospital. They are giving the services in the ICU. Commendable job. KM Hospital, Sayan Hospital, Ayer Madam, then Rajarshi Naik Madam, GMC Nagpur, Umanjali Damke Madam. Specially, I want to thank them because they are working continuously and they are making that our physiotherapist is also providing the services to the society and government. I am also thankful to Kotwal Madam, who is the HOD of YCM Center Chinchwad, Pimpri Chinchwad, YCM Hospital, because in the lockdown number one, Pimpri had the maximum number, thrice the number of Mumbai, and that was the hot spot. And where the guidelines were, nothing was there, no guideline was on the paper. In that time, Kotwal Madam and the team has taken care of COVID ward, COVID ICU. And also CMF Negdi College, Shilpa Parab Madam and her team, who is associated with the YCM Hospital, because they have given the services where there was no guidelines. So I appreciate all. I appreciate the state associations, various state associations, and also the IAP, few branches of IAP, especially West Bengal and Salem branch, who are working to protect the physiotherapists. They are providing the PPE and other services to physiotherapists. So I appreciate them. I appreciate all these things. And especially I want to mention four people. Jagat Singh, Sirsa, Haryana. Mrityunjay Kumar from Patna. BK Lamba sir and Dr. Piyush Jain. Jagat Singh is a person from Sirsa, Haryana, who is feeding the people, migrant laborers and people in the slum more than 1.5 month. In his own capacity, he is doing that. He is on the highways, he is providing food to them. As already I have mentioned, Mrityunjay Kumar, he is a frontline worker and in charge of primary screening of migrant laborer which were coming from India to Patna, Bihar. And he is doing the thermal scanning. In the morning 4 a.m. also, he is reaching to the railway station and doing that. This is commendable job. BK Lamba sir, who is feeding the animals, stray animals on the road. Senior physiotherapist, BK Lamba sir. And also for Project Ridvi, Piyush Jain. Because he has started one project in the name of his daughter and he has given groceries to the poor people, groceries for 1 or 2 months in the Delhi, Ghaziabad, Noida area, and even sitting in the Delhi, he had made arrangements to give grocery for 1-2 months to the poor families of Mumbra and Bhiwandi of Mumbai. So I appreciate all these people. These people are making the profession proud. And without mentioning that, it is difficult to comment on COVID. Now, the problems which we are facing and the questions which I got. Number one, can I start my clinic? When I should start it? This was the problem since the beginning. Lockdown number 1 to lockdown 4. Lockdown 1, it was completely that all clinics should be closed. But now people are in the mood to start the clinic. I just want to say something. The directives are different for different states. Few states said that do not open the clinics. Whereas state of Maharashtra from the beginning was of opinion that clinics should be kept open. The directives of state government, central government was clear that you have to keep that clinic open. Central government, state government, local authorities all were in this. So I just want to inform you that our stand should not violate these directions. Clinic has to be kept open. Only one thing, if it is in the containment zone, do not open your clinic. Other than that, if it is red zone, orange zone, green zone, it is mandatory on us to provide the services. Now, second thing is that if I want to start my clinic, what precaution I should take? The first precaution is that by this time we all are aware the basic social distancing precautions, mask, everything. Few points I am mentioning here because that will help you in the practice and to avoid the legal consequences. The first thing is, in clinics, our reception is inside the clinic. The first thing what you can do is you can make a entry point that is outside the main door of your clinic. One staff has to be there. Complete PPE suit has to be given to that staff. The function of that staff will be, number one, he or she will maintain the register, name, age, contact number, and he will do the initial screening, temperature screening. There has to be the thermometer, infrared or laser based thermometer has to be there. Record the fever. If the person is having fever, send him to the fever clinic. Do not allow them to enter into the clinic. Another thing is that screening of other symptoms, COVID symptoms, that has to be done, cough. We are aware of all these symptoms. If it is there, send them back to fever clinic. If they are not having anything, then give them the consent and declaration. We are going to issue the declaration and consent in a few days. So special mention has to be there that the person is declaring that I am not suffering from COVID. I have not came in contact with the COVID. I have no travel outside and inside the India. And I allow the physiotherapist to do the physiotherapy treatment to him. That kind of declaration and consent you are supposed to take. After that, what you are supposed to do in the clinic is maintain few registers. The one is patient's data. Number two, sanitization register. I repeat, sanitization register. So what you have to do in a day, whatever the sanitization procedure you are doing, enter in the register. Date, procedure, time, sign. Even it is a cleaning of floor, cleaning of instrument, bed sheet, whatever it may be, the enter that. That will help in further. I will answer in coming questions. Sanitization register has to be there. Then make a register for PPE and keep the receipts of PPE. What is this? Most of the time, some log kya karte ki we purchase the PPE from nearest store. Hum kabhi receipt nahi lete. Try to avoid that. Jitna bhi purchase kar rahe ho, whatever may be the purchase of PPE, sanitization, or the sanitizer, liquids, consumables, mask, cotton, take a proper bill, take a receipt, file it. And how many, for example, in this month I have taken 30 N95 masks. At the end of month, I have 10. 20 N95 masks were given to my staff. Maintain that. That will help in the law of court. I will get back to this again. Then maintain the register of PPEs, receipts of all these equipments, and ask the patient to download the Arogya Setu app and update every time whenever the person is visiting. Now next thing is that care of treatment and electrodes, especially electrotherapy machines, we have to take the care. It has to be sanitized every patient, the electrodes has to be properly sanitized. The clinic has to be sterilized or disinfectant has to be used. 1% sodium hypochlorite that you can use. Sanitizers having 70% and more alcohol that you can use it. So entire clinic has to be clean. Then the mattresses or bed sheets. Here I will suggest you to use the plastic sheets, plastic bed sheet, plastic covers. If it is use and throw, good. If not, you can with the different sprays you can sterilize, you can disinfect it. So use that, and after every patient make a habit that you are doing it and document somewhere so that you will not have the problem. Regarding the manual therapy, try to avoid as much as possible. If it is not avoidable, you can take the precaution that skin wherever you are giving that area has to be cleaned, sanitized with different materials, and then you can go for that. So this has the cares which we have to take. We will give a detailed directive on this also. Now, next commonly asked question is that patient coming to clinic, if the patient is coming to my clinic, becomes positive, corona positive, what action will be taken on me? So question is, patient was taking treatment from you and someday you came to know that the patient is positive, what action will be taken on me? So the first thing is that whenever the patient is coming to your clinic, you are maintaining all the registers, you are maintaining the sanitization, you are maintaining the PPE, everything you are doing, so you are safe. If something is notice is given, you are easily you can tackle that. Second thing is that it is difficult to prove that the patient got the infection in your clinic. The patient is coming from his home during the travel, coming and going back to home. Probably patient has got that infection. It is difficult for anyone to prove that the infection was from the clinic. If you are taking all these precautions and if you are documenting it, nothing will be done in this regard. So we are supposed to take care of that. Now second question is that can my clinic will be sealed if the patient becomes positive, mera clinic seal hoga ya nahi, and what will be the procedure? I think this question has created a great fear in the physiotherapist. We are supposed to find the answer. To get the answer, we should understand the government directive. 15 days, within the 15 days, outside the 15 days. If the patient is coming to you, taking the treatment and now he become positive, then what will happen? The authorities will inquire for the contact history. And whenever there is a contact history, definitely authority will come to your clinic. What the first thing people are afraid that authority will take action on me. The first thing which will be done by authority is they will take your test. Second, they will check your clinic. And as I said, if you are maintaining all these registers, you are following all the precautions, the authorities will get convinced that you have followed it. So nothing will be done to you. Only one thing they will do. For 24 hours, for one day, they will close the clinic and government authority will do sanitization, disinfection and fumigation of clinic. And they will close the clinic. They will quarantine you till your report comes. If report is negative, you can resume the clinic. Clinic will not get sealed. If report comes positive, they will take you. Initial phases, this was happened, hospitals were sealed because government was not having any clear-cut guidelines, and that was a hospital. For clinics, sealing of clinics is not happening now in the lockdown 3 and 4. So this is a legal thing. There is no need to afraid that your clinic will become sealed. It will take. If it is more than 15 days, that means last month the patient came and after he get become positive and the person is coming to you and reporting, nothing will be done to you because it is beyond 15 days. 15 days is the period of given by the government authorities. So can my clinic will be sealed? No. If you follow everything, nothing will happen to you. Now next question is that in case my clinic spread infection, does any legal case proceeding action will be done on me? This we are supposed to know it. People have great fear about this. गलती से अगर मेरे यहाँ पे कुछ होता है, इन्फेक्शन स्प्रेड हुआ ऐसे होता है, तो मेरे ऊपर एक्शन होगी या नहीं कोर्ट में? वी हैव टू नो द बेसिक्स ऑफ दिस लीगल प्रोविजंस. तो फर्स्ट थिंग एज आई सेड, इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू प्रूव दैट पेशेंट गॉट इन्फेक्शन इन योर क्लिनिक ओनली. इट इज डिफिकल्ट, नोबडी कैन प्रूव दैट. नंबर टू, if you are maintaining all these things, register, consent, daily basis you are taking the sign, declaration on the declaration, then and you are following the disinfection, maintaining the register, receipts of PPE, nothing will happen to you. Even if the person will reach to the court, nothing will happen to you because you have taken this. Point number three here, what you are supposed to understand, government has forced us to keep the clinic open. Various state and central government has given the directives saying physiotherapists should keep their clinic open. They have given the directives. Just remember this. The directives are given under the provisions of Epidemic Act 1897. Epidemic Act 1897, under that these directives are given and they are asking us to keep the open clinic open. There is a beauty of this act, the act which is by that we can't resist them. We can't say no, we have to follow that. But the same act gives us the protection. Section 4 of Epidemic Act 1897 gives the legal protection to all healthcare workers. I repeat, Section 4 of Epidemic Act. What it says? It says that in case of enforcement of this act, no legal proceedings will be carried out against the treating healthcare worker because this is an act taken in the good faith. Meaning, even someone goes to the court, by the Section 4 of Epidemic Act, that act cannot be taken as a negligence, deviation from the standards of practice, and legal proceedings will not be carried against you. Just try to remember this. Section 4 of Epidemic Act. Khuda na khasta koi gaya court mein. Some special provisions request and court has accepted the PIL. Now what to do? The case is against you. The person is saying that you have done the negligence. The beauty of Indian medical laws is that the negligence has to be proved by patient and not by the doctor. Agar maine negligence kiya hai, मुझे डिफेंड नहीं करना है कि मैंने निग्लिजेंस नहीं किया है. पेशेंट को प्रूव करना है कि ये डॉक्टर ने निग्लिजेंस किया है. दिस इज अ ब्यूटी. सो द हियर द टास्क इज टू द पेशेंट. पेशेंट हैज टू प्रूव दैट दिस इज अ रॉन्ग प्रैक्टिस हैज डन बाय द डॉक्टर. नाउ अगर केस होता है, दैट्स व्हाई आई सेड रजिस्टर ऑफ सैनिटाइजेशन, डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ द पेशेंट, आरोग्य सेतु ऐप एंड the receipts of PPE. This will save you in the court. You can show this to the court that I have done this every time after the patient. I have done in a twice, thrice, four times in a day. I have disinfected my clinic, these are the receipts, and make the payment by non-cash method. If you are purchasing PPE, debit card, credit card, wallets, make that, because that is also proof. So in that case, you will not get anything. Another one thing to prove that you have taken all the care is that in clinic, put the pictures of all the precaution measures, safety measures, hand washing, social distancing, mask, whatever is there, so many. If you will Google it, you will get all that. Take a printout and put it in the different parts of clinic. Take the photo of that. Uska photo le lo and keep it in the file. That means it proves that this healthcare worker, this doctor has taken all the necessary precautions. And if someone files a case against you, number one, section 4 will not allow the legal proceeding. Court will not take that into the consideration. Second thing, it will prove that you have taken all the precautions. So no legal proceeding will be done against you. So physiotherapists who are thinking that this law will kill my practice, nothing will happen to you. So if you are not opening the clinic because of this, no need to afraid of it. Manage the patients without the fear of law. And we are with you. Now, next question is that if a notice is given to me, what I should do? Because हमें क्या लगता है notice मिला यानि मेरे against action हुआ है. ऐसे कुछ भी नहीं है. Notice is the way government has observed something and you have to give a reply to them. If you will give a convincing reply, that notice will be closed. So that we are supposed to have. What happened in my area, Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation has given a notice to one of our senior lady physiotherapy practitioner, and they said that on that particular day, particular time, Municipal Corporation squad was in your area and we have found that your clinic was closed. Give the explanation why action should not be taken within 72 hours. So madam reported me. I have just given the draft with 3 or 4 lines. We informed the corporation that my clinic is working on the appointment basis. The duration of opening of clinic is not fixed. It varies from number of patient, and I am practicing this appointment basis to prevent the infection of corona. The day on which you have came, on that day there was no appointment. Hence the clinic was not open on that day. The next day there were the appointments. I have opened the clinic. This justification was accepted by the corporation. They said it is accepted, satisfied and closed. So notice does not mean that it is an action. Another thing is that in the lockdown 1, there is one company which provides home care services. They were giving the legal notice to our physiotherapist. I think 32, 33 physiotherapists were there and they were forcing to take the home visit call. All were refusing it. Definitely in that period it was expected from everyone that they will refuse it, and the company was saying if you'll refuse, we'll take the legal action on you. Now the thing is that in such situation, what we are supposed to do? So they contacted me. I said, do not say that we will not do the calls. Say we are ready to do the calls, because the moment you will say I am not ready to do this call or this duty, action will be taken on you. You are liable. Company gets the advantage and legally they can sue you. Now in that situation, what I said, just draft an email and say that we are ready to serve the needy patients in the COVID, because we think it is our responsibility. We'll provide the services, we'll attend the call subject to the fulfillment of these conditions. Number one, pick and drop facility from the home of physiotherapist because transport was closed. Number two, medical certificate and corona test report of the cab driver who is coming to pick the physio on daily basis. Number three, the NOC, no objection certificate from society, residential society, to allow the entry of physiotherapist to treat the patient. No society does that. I am also office bearer of my society. Government has clearly given orders, do not allow anyone outside the society. Number four, the medical certificate and corona reports of patient and family on daily basis. Number five, the PPE for physiotherapist. Number six, the police pass of transport for physiotherapist. Number six, seven, the insurance not less than 50 lakhs. Demand this, we are ready to do it, the services. 30 to 33 physiotherapists, they mailed on the same day. Company said, we'll revert back soon. That was lockdown number one. Now it is lockdown number four. Company haven't reverted yet. So, notice does not mean that it is an action taken on you. It is a opportunity to give present yourself to that particular authority. So do not afraid of notice. Notices will be given this. Now next question is that, can government acquire my services? Yes. Epidemic Act is in force, Disaster Management Act is there, and Maharashtra Corona Act 2020, it is also in force. So, government has all the rights to take, acquire your services. Can I refuse that services? No. You can't refuse that services on routine grounds. Only on specific medical grounds you can reject it. The first thing is that if you are corona positive, definitely duty can be rejected, or serious medical complication, illness. Other than that, you can't refuse that duty. If I refuse, what action will be taken on me? My registration will be cancelled. Definitely, if you refuse the duty given by the government authorities, action will be taken on you. All the councils in the Maharashtra has got the letters from the Medical Education Ministry, because DMER is the authority as per the Corona Act 2020. They can acquire your services. If government has acquired your services and if you are refusing, government has informed all the councils to cancel the registration. Absolutely true. It is possible. Your registration will be cancelled. Now the thing is that, can my next question was that, can my institute force me to do the duties? Government, definitely yes. Private institute which has a COVID center, can they force employees to do it? Yes, they can do it. If it is a government approved COVID center, they have the rights to do that. But, private institutes has to follow the protocol. Few complaints have been received from Maharashtra, outside Maharashtra also, where they are not providing anything to the physiotherapist and they are forcing physios to accept the COVID duties. Action kab hogi? Jab aapke institute ne sab facilities provide kiya hai and then you are refusing. Number one, insurance. Insurance, the basic thing is that you should have a deployment letter. Government ne aapki services acquired kiya hai, uska letter chahiye. If institute is not giving, private institute is not giving that, they have no right to report to the council and government to take the action on the physiotherapist. Those institutes, private institutes, which are forcing the physiotherapist to accept the duties without giving insurance, accommodation facilities and proper PPE, they can't claim for the action. I repeat, I got few complaints from the Maharashtra. If that institutes are forcing the physiotherapist, my physiotherapist, to take the COVID duties without giving the insurance and deployment letter, and if you are reporting to the government and the council, we will inquire your case and we will take action on you. You have no right to put my physiotherapist in the difficult situation. If you are giving PPE, if you are giving 50 lakhs insurance of state government, if you are giving deployment letter signed by the authorities of COVID authorities, sanctioned by the government of Maharashtra, residence to them, and my physiotherapist is refusing that, then you have the claim to report to the government and council. Without doing that, if you are torturing my physiotherapist, and if it will come on the paper, we will take action on you. So just try to understand, there is a protocol, private hospitals, private COVID centers has to follow it. Simply, you are not allowed to threaten physiotherapist so that you will cancel their registrations. Aise to hoga nahi. Aapne bola, government or council ne registration cancel kiya. Hoga to nahi. So follow the procedure and then report to the government and council. So your institute can force you, but they should follow the protocol given by the government. And I was unfortunate to see that physiotherapists are not, private hospital are not doing this. So they have no claim to threaten the physiotherapist to cancel the registration. If you are doing threatening my physiotherapist, we will take action on you. Next question is that police permission is needed for transport for clinic. Lockdown number one, it was mandatory from the government that police pass is required for treatment. Now, after that, government has said that the pass is not required. Your council registered ID card, hospital card, clinic card is ID card is sufficient for this. Lockdown 1, personally I have taken a pass from the police, and when it is extended in lockdown 2, I applied for that. Police rejected my pass, saying that there is no need for the travel pass for a healthcare worker. So there is no need. I came to know from the social media that some physiotherapist in the Mumbai was beaten up by the police. He claimed that even after saying he is a physiotherapist, the police has beaten him. This is from the social media. I have never got anything from the police. That area from the Mumbai, I tried to find out. There is no written complaint. If something is happening to you, give the complaint to the police or the respective authority. Without that, it is difficult. Now, claiming that I am a physiotherapist, I am going for the treatment to a police without the ID card of the council, then it is difficult. Because अपना इंडिया इतना जुगाड़ू है कि सब पब्लिक बोलती है मैं डॉक्टर हॉस्पिटल स्टाफ हूँ एंड आई एम गोइंग देयर. सो पुलिस विल इंक्वायर इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग द आईडी कार्ड एंड इफ यू आर फाइटिंग आर्ग्यूइंग विद द पुलिस, पुलिस विल टेक एक्शन. सो कैरी यूर आईडी कार्ड्स, काउंसिल आईडी कार्ड्स. आई गॉट अ फीडबैक फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर महाराष्ट्र दैट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ आईडी कार्ड पुलिस हैज अलाउड अस टू एंटर इन एनी एरिया. One case which I came, that is also from the social media. There was a second case from the Thane, where I got a call from a physio that, sir, even after showing the ID card, the police is not allowing. I said, arre, council ka card dikha do, allow karega. Then he said, please speak to the police. So the police was not ready to speak. One officer spoke. I said, sir, he is a member of council, please allow him to go. He is going to the treatment. So police said, sahib, tumhala chukicha sangtay. What happened? The candidate is saying wrong, sir. It is 7:30 p.m. After 7 there is a curfew. The person is saying that he is going to treat the patient for home visit. The person is on the slipper, Bermuda and sleeveless t-shirt, and he is trying to pass through the containment zone. So police, if you are, whatever you are speaking, that has your action and your information should match. If you are on the slippers, sleeveless t-shirt and Bermuda and trying to enter a containment zone and you want to go to the some other zone, even I will not allow, because your action should meet with the information. So these are the two things which I came to, one directly, one from the social media. So carry your ID cards, that will help you. If there is any problem, you can contact to me personally, I will talk. Now also give the ID cards to your clinic staff, because that is required. Clinical staff, they are not having any ID card, so give the clinic ID card to them. Now next question is, there was huge debate on this. Physiotherapy is an emergency service or not? Then why we should treat the patient, why we should open if it is not emergency? And many, many people had a difference of opinion on this. One way we say that we are doctors. One way we say that we have to do this. But I will not go in the detail of this, whether physiotherapy is an emergency or not. To the best of my knowledge, there is no legal document which says physiotherapy is an emergency, or there is no document which says that physiotherapy is not emergency. But there are the documents, acts, which says that chest physiotherapy is the life-saving treatment modality. Whether chest physiotherapy is emergency or not, I don't know, because there is no document, and if it is, unless it is on the paper, I never say. But there are the documents which says chest physiotherapy is life-saving modality. Maharashtra State Act 2nd of 2004, Clause 2I, describes physiotherapy as the life-saving modality in ICU. The same clause, the definition has been taken by the Gujarat government, Chhattisgarh government, Punjab government, Andhra Pradesh government. So all these legal documents says that physiotherapy is life-saving. I don't know whether it is emergency, and I will not try to put my foot in this debate at this moment. Later, we have to work to get the recognition on paper. So physiotherapy is a life-saving modality. Then why we are supposed to work? Chest physiotherapy wale kaam karenge ICU mein? Hame kyun aap duty pe laga rahe ho? So the thing is that Disaster Act says that all the healthcare services, they are essential services. That means what? All the healthcare services are essential services. Hence, we have to provide the service. Physiotherapy is emergency or not, I don't know. But physiotherapy is essential. Chest physiotherapy is life-saving. We have to do that. Now, the thing is that in ICU, if you see the central government protocol, physiotherapy is not included in the treatment protocol. We have to understand, we have to accept it. Government, central government has given, included us in the administrative work. Administration work, in that this is done. Now, thing is that in such situation, ICU mein jo physiotherapist kaam karta hai, he will not get coverage under the insurance, because central government ka nahi milega. Central government mein dala hi nahi hai physiotherapist ko in treatment protocol of ICU patient. State government, what it has done, Maharashtra, there was a mortality rate was high, so there was a task force appointed by the government of Maharashtra. Government of Maharashtra task force has recommended government to take the measures which will reduce the mortality, and the direction was given to the Mumbai commissioner. Mumbai commissioner has given the guideline, and the guideline has clearly stated that physiotherapy should be included into this treatment protocol to reduce the mortality, and the deployment letters in the name of chest physiotherapist were given. If you are doing this, definitely the insurance coverage will be there. If it is not there, insurance coverage will not be given to the physiotherapist who is treating the patient in the ICU. Now, next question is that, can I start my pediatric setup? And can I treat 60 plus geriatric patient? From the lockdown 1 to lockdown 4, one thing was constant in the guideline, that children less than 10 and adults more than 60 on geriatric population, they should not come out of the home. This was the guideline from first to last. This is absolutely clear. Now, thing is that this question I got from Nagpur. They said that surgeons are operating on 60 plus patient, and they are saying that after that rehabilitation, do not go to the physiotherapist, do not do the rehabilitation, and they instructed a few physios that not to do it because it is vulnerable population. Absolutely correct. It is a vulnerable population. Now, thing is that a vulnerable population can get operated but can't get rehabilitated. The person can, surgical procedure can be performed but exercises cannot be performed. Mujhe thoda samajh mein nahi aata hai. This guideline is for general population, below 10, above 60, general population. Without any cause, you should not come outside. If there is a medical cause, you can come outside. So if the patient is coming to your clinic, first two lockdown, even the immunization was on hold. Now they have permitted the immunization. Iska midway kya hoga? Patients are pediatric patient with CP and everything, they need the treatment. If they are coming, you have to give it. Agar aapka personal setup chalu karna hai, toh midway is that, do the consultation. First consult, one consultation in detail, and home exercise program, and take the care of home exercise program. So that you are supposed to do. You can use the tele-rehabilitation services, tele-consultation services, and on that basis, see that the progress of the patient. If you want to reduce the risk of this vulnerable population, you can follow this. One detailed consulting, home exercise program, and follow up by 3 days, 4 days, 1 week, and with tele-rehabilitation or even WhatsApp call. Few physios are already doing that. Excellent. Every problem has opportunity. They found it. So we are supposed to do that. So similar for the geriatric population. If the person is operated and needs the rehabilitation, we have to consult at least one setting in detail and home exercise program. Can I do home visit? This was the problem, because home visit is a sector where we get a lot of revenue. Physiotherapy, this is completely affected. The major first effect was on these people. So what we are supposed to do, whether we are supposed to do the home visit, lockdown one, absolutely it was clear that you should not do it. Now, the answer to this question varies from place to place. If you are in the green zone, you can do it with precautions. If you are in the orange zone, you can do it. If it is in the red zone, additional care has to be taken. Contentment, no. If you are in the cities, metro cities, where residential societies are there, societies should allow you. Societies are not allowing. Even aapko jaake dena hai, you will not get that. If you are in the district and tehsil place, taluk place, and there is no societies, you can treat it. But not at the cost of compromise in the safety. You have to take the PPE for the practice also in the clinic. We are aware that you have to have a N95 mask, you have to have the face shield, then you should have the goggle. If face shield is there, that is fine. Then you should have the shoe cover and proper PP suit. If it is not there, full length gown, it has to be there. So you now at this moment, you can think for home visit. If you are in the green zone, if you are in the containment zone, city like Mumbai, my personal advice is there, Mumbai, Thane, Navi Mumbai, that try to avoid it. Now next is, do I need permission from pollution control board? This question has asked in last 15-20 days. I always say, if you are practicing dry needling, take it. Now I will suggest that even you are not practicing it, take it. Because corona se hamara practice affect hone wala hai. We are taking the precautions. We are practicing the sterilization technique. We are practicing the sanitization technique. We are maintaining the register of sanitization, receipts of all. Better do this also. किसी को आपके अगेंस्ट जाना भी है, पर्सनल खुन्नस भी निकालना है कंपनी क्लिनिक के अगेंस्ट, इफ यू हैव द पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड सर्टिफिकेट इन फ्यू हंड्रेड्स टू थाउजेंड यू विल गेट दैट फॉर अ ईयर. इफ इट इज इन देयर लीगल यू आर कंप्लीटली क्लियर. ऑल स्टेट बोर्ड सर्टिफिकेट्स इफ इट इज इजी टू टेक प्लीज टेक दैट. नाउ टेक thing is that can the I do tele-rehabilitation or tele-consultation, whether there is any guideline. You can do the tele-rehabilitation, tele-consultation at this moment. Unfortunately, there is no guideline in relation to tele-rehabilitation in India. Telemedicine, there is a guideline. Corona will teach us to create such kind of guidelines. Now, thing is that legality we are not aware, but some sort of consent has to be taken. Video recording has to be done to prove that you have not done anything wrong. So at this moment there are no guidelines, but you can do the tele-rehabilitation, tele-consultation. Standardization of PPE. Many people are asking, sir, ye to aisa mila ki jahan se yahan se DO maar diya to bhi. On the other end, there you can see the so that is not appropriate. So what are the guidelines for standardization? So I will not go in the detail, I will just share two certifications are necessary as per the central government, that is CITRA, Coimbatore, and second one is DRDA, Defense Organization, which certifies the PPE companies. So if you are having, they have given the list on their website, purchase that company. They have given unique code on that particular PPE unit, check that. If you are in the Maharashtra, along with this, there is a Hafkin. Hafkin is a government body which purchases for the hospitals. And on the website, they have given the list of the accredited vendors. Their rates are also less. They are in the government rate. They are mandatory to sell at the government rate to the government hospitals, and if you are having bulk orders, they are giving it at the government rate including the GST. So it's my request to all the practitioners, instead of purchasing individually, see to it that your district, your place, your city, your association will give the bulk order. Take the receipts of that, take the distribution of that, maintain the records, you will get. So CITRA, DRDA and Hafkin, these are the things. Now question is asked regarding the rent and EMI. Sir, anything can be done in relation to this? Definitely, this is not related to the council or bodies, but this is a major concern of physiotherapist. We should not ignore this. Rent in the clinics is an issue where the practices are reduced, cash flow is reduced, but the rent is not. We have to give it. EMIs are also there. Government has made a provision for EMI. Government has given guidelines to RBI. Banks are following. But in this issue, directives are not mandatory. Government has requested the landowners to consider for this. South Mumbai, I got calls. The rent is huge. In lakhs for a 200 square feet clinic. So if everything is closed down, what can be done? So just it's request to all that you have to communicate with the landowners and inform them that central and state government has requested you. Legally, we can't dictate them, but we can request them. If a better communication is there, they will also consider it. But legally, it is difficult to put anything on the paper in relation to the rent. Now, next question is guidelines for chest physiotherapy, physiotherapy rehabilitation in COVID hospital and non-COVID hospital. WCPT has given a wonderful guideline in relation to the physiotherapy practice in the COVID ICU and hospital. We have to follow that. For mild and moderate cases, there is no need of chest physiotherapy. Clearly, they have informed there is no need for other interventions also. If the patient is in the COVID ward, active intervention is not necessary because lung damage is not taken to that level or there is not necessity if you compare with the risk. If it is in the ICU, definitely chest physiotherapy becomes mandatory. Chest physiotherapy, ARDS is the complication, pneumonia is complication, infiltrates are there, and to reduce the mortality, Maharashtra government has asked the authorities to include chest physiotherapy. We have to give that. During this, all procedures are aerosol generating procedures. Closed suction should be prioritized, and that is followed everywhere in the COVID ICUs. If there is a places in the district hospital where closed or taluka tehsil hospitals, rural hospitals, if the closed suction facility is not available, then we have to take a lot of precautions. So some oxy hood, larger side oxy hood you can use, and to reduce that aerosol, something has to be done. Or the way few hospitals are using the sheets, different sheets covering and doing the suction, that way you have to tackle. But most of the tertiary care, we have the closed suction system that will solve most of the problems. Care has to be taken in oral suction. Oral suction, whatever may be set up, you have to take the care, and complete PPE is required. Do not put the life of physiotherapist. Their incidents happened in the lockdown one, even the repeated corporate hospital with a simple N95 mask and the gloves, they force physiotherapists to do the chest physiotherapy in ICU. If it is a patient of COVID, government guideline is too clear. Even if you want to enter the ward, PPE suit has to be there. Provide that. Now question is that what physiotherapy has to be given into the physiotherapist in the COVID patient in the ward? Our fraternity is saying that we have to give them breathing exercises, we have to, so that we can prevent. Absolutely correct, we can give it. Ideally, there is no need. Guidelines are saying that mild moderate cases, there is no need. But if you want to give breathing exercise, if you want to prove that physiotherapy is helpful, and if you want physiotherapist to go there, and simultaneously if you want to lower down the risk, we have to think the risk and benefit. So simple middle way is there. What you can do, I got a call from one of the district place, and their superintendent was forcing physiotherapist to do the breathing exercises to all COVID ward patient. So I said, what you do, shoot a simple video, harik ke pass WhatsApp hai, circulate on the WhatsApp, that's it. No need to enter into the ward and go to the patient and teach how to cough, how to do the exercises. Because guidelines ne bola hai ki mild moderate mein zarurat nahi. If there is no requirement, we should not put patients, physios at the risk. So we can do that. That was one question. If non in COVID ward, what we are supposed to do, we can tackle this. You can use technology and you can minimize the interference. Question was asked regarding the manipulation technique. If you have any question, you can put it into the I think most of the question which I have asked that I have covered. If you have anything else, you can put it here. And the question was related to the manipulation technique, whether we have to use it or not. There is a skin contact, definitely yes. If it is possible, try to avoid as much as possible. If not, then you can take the precaution. That area has to be properly sanitized. You are already using the gloves. Double gloves can be used, because that person is not having the respiratory complication. If the person is negative, even you have to take the care. Positive to definitely aayega hi nahi hamare paas. So that we are supposed to take into the course. There are so many questions I tried to answer. I think it is more than 1 hour 15 minutes. If you have any question, you can put into the comment box. But just try to understand that the question is that what is exactly deployment letter? Deployment letter kya hota hai? Simple hai. See, my hospital is also having the COVID center in Nerul East. There is a COVID floor, COVID ward. 5 minutes on the other side, Nerul East, there is a government hospital. So mere yahan pe patients nahi hai. But agar tomorrow patients come, what we do? Positive aa gaya to wo government corporation wale leke jaate. But tomorrow the flow there is, now it is getting full, so the patient will come to my hospital. My hospital administration want me to give chest physiotherapy to the patient. That is COVID duty. COVID patient. Non-COVID hai to there is no issue. COVID patient, if I want to treat that, mujhe to aap PPE dene wale ho, no issue. You can give the residence. But you have to give me the letter. The COVID center in charge has to sign that following physiotherapists are deployed, or the rotation posting rota. Posting rota is given to them in the COVID for 15 days, followed by 15 days quarantine period. And that letter has to be signed by authority. If that letter is there, it is considered as an official assignment. If it is not there, then there is it is not there. We will not get the insurance. If you are getting that letter, there is one in charge in the center. You have to just give the copy to them and see to it that your name will come in that insurance list. Without this letter, you will not get the insurance. Private hospital, if you are asking the employees to do that, please check. It is, there are some questions in this. I'm trying to, if you have any question, please put it. Most of the questions are already. Postural drainage can be given, secretion retention, ERDS case, or definitely we have to give that. We can't, and even chest postural drainage will also create a lot of, it is also one way aerosol generation technique. We have to give that. With precaution, we are supposed to give that. What is your opinion about the mucrofogging machines to disinfect the clinic? Nowadays such kind of productions are increased. Many companies are claiming that you can utilize that, but see to it that if you will have the standardized agencies which has given this, if you are doing that, you can for fumigation, you can utilize that. There are some machines which are also given for the disinfections. I think it is better than having nothing, or simple, with the simple spray and bottle also you can do that. But if you want to fumigate, disinfect the floors also, roof, you can use that. One question is there, pediatric physiotherapy guidelines. We have to work in this in detail. A few centers, they are already hospital setups, they are providing the services. If you are having private clinic, pediatric, I am repeating that, try to have a one detailed consultation and give some home exercise program through the videos, WhatsApp call, or any other medium. You can be in contact with them. We have to treat. If you are opening the pediatric clinic, make it that it is kept on the rotation, like after 3 days, 4 days, 1 week, that kind of pattern, you can start with it. And whatever we have discussed, disinfection, same you have to follow with that. But CP child and all other child, they have the problem with the drooling of saliva, and this additional precaution has to be taken in this relation. Unfortunately, there is no guideline for pediatric rehabilitation, separate guideline. International guide agencies also have not given this. So we have to wait for some time in this regard. Arogya Setu app, do we need to check? Yes. See, this. What is this? The patient is reporting himself. If there are some signs, he is reporting, automatically the application will suggest to visit the nearest fever clinic. This you have to do. And second thing, if someone has intention to take you to the court, this will be helpful. What we are doing, we have taken one declaration consent, and at the back side, put the name, date and sign, so that every day the patient is signing on that declaration that today I am not having this fever or everything. And same the person is reporting to the Arogya Setu app. If there is a discrepancy, if the patient has reported there but he has not reported to you, he is saying that I am not suffering but he has reported there, there is a mismatch. If he is going to court, action can be taken. Even though if you will delete the data is with the government. If he is not reporting there and also not reporting to you and came positive, you are at safe. Even you are doing the temperature scanning. Usme bhi agar nahi aaya, but the person become positive. So Arogya Setu app, check that on daily basis. I think most of the questions we have tried to answer it. I am again thankful to everyone for patiently listening this, I think more than 1 hour 20 minutes. And I really appreciate the physiotherapist of the country. In COVID, without the guidelines from the directives from the government and with few national international guidelines, we are taking the care. Physiotherapists are the integral part of this healthcare profession. And this is a time to prove government that we are the equal partners in the healthcare. And I'm really happy that people are coming forward, not only to treat the COVID, non-COVID, but also providing services to the society. I take this as an opportunity. As an administrator in COVID and after COVID, so many reforms will take place in healthcare sector. The people, government authorities are now in the mood to think on this sector. Pehle kaise tha ki health mein kya karna hai, physiotherapy ka kya karna hai, recruitment rule, appointment, rehne do. Now government is in the serious mood. The bureaucrats, technocrats, they got the directives from the government that you have to change the system. So reforms will take place, and this is a time where as a physiotherapist we should prove the government that we are the stakeholders of this healthcare profession. I hope that if you start efforts today, somewhere 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, we will get something positive and a respectable place in the healthcare sector for physiotherapy. Here I want to stop. I'm thankful for you all for listening this, for your questions. There are so many questions. If you have any questions, you can put later. I will answer by text there. Just one thing I would like to share. As a regulatory authority, we are there with you individually. As a physiotherapist and physiotherapy activist, I am with you. Even though it is out of the jurisdiction of a council, but as an individual professional, I am with you. There is no need to fear about the law, but follow something. Thank you very much, and thank you for joining me. Stay safe at home and at workplace. Cheers to physiotherapy.